Hey there, Xactimate users. I'm certified trainer Lance Reeves.
Hey, I'm Jenny Quartz, a training employee for Verisk.
Welcome to your fast pass to estimating with success.
In today's video, we're going to be talking about the three speedy moves every estimator should know in Xactimate.
Using category and selector codes to add line items, quickly finding related items, and setting up macros. These aren't just neat features, they're workflow game changers. First up is using category and selector codes. Knowing your codes helps you scope claims much faster without wasting clicks. Let's get into it. Every line item in Xactimate has two parts, a category code and a selector code. Think of the category code as a trade, like PNT for paint or DRY for drywall. And the selector code as a specific item within that trade, like half-inch drywall or latex paint. The category code is always three characters, while the selector code can range from one to sometimes even seven characters. There are thousands of items in Xactimate, so learning the codes of some of the more commonly used items will definitely speed things up. You can find the full list of codes using the category and selector smart lists in Xactimate and manually add items that way. By clicking into the drop-down arrow next to category, this will bring up a list of all the categories that you can choose from. I'm going to go ahead and choose light fixtures and click OK. With the category now filled in, if I click on the drop-down for the selector code, this is now every line item in the light fixtures category, ranging from light fixtures agreed price all the way down to exterior light fixtures detach and reset, and everything in between. To add the item in, you can just select it and then click OK. Now, when you do this, the item is in the quick entry field where we can see the description, we can see the calculation, we can see the unit price, but the item is not added into the room until we click OK. This method is nice, but learning the codes, those commonly used codes, that can speed things up immensely. Now you can do this in the quick entry field. Like if I wanted to add a high grade light fixture, then I need to click OK or press Enter. But you can also do this down in the item list itself by clicking into the category field and adding a few items. Put some drywall in there, paint, smoke detector, carpet, and more. It's the fastest way of doing things. And we get it. Knowing your codes is one thing, but recognizing what's actually at the loss site, that's a whole other skill. That's where the CBE Construction Basics and Estimation courses come in. It's a video library that helps you identify materials on site so you can select the right line item in Xactimate. It's like having a construction coach in your back pocket, minus the tool belt. You can check it out at learn.xactware.com.
Let's talk about related items. Here's why it matters. Related items save you time with less clicks and ensure that you're not missing essential components of a job, keeping your estimate consistent and complete, especially if you're new to Xactimate. These are items that are commonly used together with the line item you've already added to your estimate. Let's say you're in the bedroom and you want to add a new carpet line item. First, head over to the Estimate Items tab and select the room or area you're working in. That's our starting point. Type carpet into the keyword search and select standard grade. From the items list, select the line item you just added. Yeah, the carpet one. Click the related link and boom, there you have it. Xactimate opens up a panel with a list of additional items typically used alongside the one you picked. This list might include things like cleaning, padding, or anything that commonly goes hand in hand with your main item. It's like having a smart assistant who's also a contractor whispering, hey, don't forget about this stuff. Now you can add the related line items by simply double-clicking it. Or you can right-click it and select add to estimate. You can adjust the quantities right here if you need to, and voila, quick, clean, done. If you want to find line items that serve a similar function or have variations, then you would select the similar link. This is helpful when you're not 100% sure of the exact material or style used at the law site. It gives you options without needing to start your search over. Just like you did earlier, double click, and now the line item has been added to your list.
Finally, let's talk about the holy grail of speed, macros. Macros eliminate repetition and help you estimate faster with consistent line items. If you find yourself adding the same cluster of items over and over, like for water losses or roof replacements, create a macro. To create a macro in the item list, select the items you want to have in your macro by clicking on the top one, holding down Shift, and clicking on the last item. You can also right-click on an item and choose Select All, or use the shortcut Control-A. Once your items are selected, the Quick Entry field disappears, and you're given three options. Simply select Save Macro. A menu will pop up where you name your macro, and you can give a simple description of it. There are other options in here. We're going to skip those for now. I'll complete the save by clicking on OK. This macro is now saved to your account and can be used in any estimate you work on. To load the macro, first select the room you want it to go in. In the search field, right above where it says Quick Entry, there's a Macros tab. Click on that and you'll see all the macros you have access to, whether it's ones that you have created or macros that have been shared with you. I'm going to go ahead and choose the macro we created. And you can either click Run in the top right corner, or you can double click on the macro and that will load it into the room that you have selected. Here's a quick tip. If you have light fixtures or other EA or each items, then you can set the quantities to zero before saving the macro, so you're not stuck with weird numbers next time. But you should always double check to make sure your quantities match your scope. Otherwise, items that are square footage or linear footage calculations will automatically adjust based on the room you place them in. And that's how you create and use macros.
If you're ready to go deeper like certified level deep, head to learn.xactware.com. There you'll find CPE, full courses, and certification options that'll put your Xactimate skills on the map.